stare back at him. I can't go with this. All right, hold it down. Hold it down, fella. Can't hear anything.
We better get the mics a little louder because the throats are in.
Mine's gone already. Stepped on a line.
I did not.
They can't hear
this. We can't hear ourselves. Come on, Johnny. Stop getting around. Put the microphones on. I'm not bored.
One, two, one, two.
Come on. Put them on.
One, two, one, two.
Come on.
There. Now, is that so hard?
One, two. Crazy. Leave it like that.
All right, let's rehearse it one.
No, why'd rehearse it? We're going to do the whole show again at 10.
Wait. You talk for a minute. You want to tell me about Betty Corwett?
Like listen, we're going to do a little thing. Don't all talk
right,
to me
don't
when... Don't talk.
Or you'll wind up going back to Sicily. And you'll deserve it, too. He used to work in a grape factory, stepping on grapes, but they fired him. They
why?
Caught him sitting down on a job.
You want to rehearse this Betty Coed thing, or you just want to make this a rumor?
Now, why change your style?
I don't know what I'd do without him, but I'd rather.
Yeah, I'd shake hands with you, but I see you're busy.
Jerry, you... Well, there goes NBC license.
You want to rehearse it once, run it down quickly. Betty Coed. Dean, run it down with him. He knows. You know better than music.
I don't
than
want anything. I don't know music.
Well, if you don't, we better not even start this show. We're having loads of fun. I wish you'd join us.
All right, let's try. From what right. top? All right, let's do the whole gut. Let's do the whole show. I'm
hold
sorry.
It, please, for a picture. Thank you.
Crazy.
All right. Great picture.
All right, Jerry, get that one big buff, and then we'll go right on the air.
All
there's nothing like a big buff, right? You know, before we go.
Yeah, we have to get a big lap before we go on the air. How can you look so clean and laugh so dirty? Okay? You ready, Rich?
No, you're ready.
I'm ready. Always ready.
How come you put all your money in clothes like this? Look at this. Hey, we'll be here until Pesach. Come on.
Rim bam bee, kick him in the knee. Rim bam bass, kick him in the other knee.
From Hollywood, we present the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show. Brought to you by Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor, and Chiclet, the candy-coated gum with a flavor that won't chew out. By Chesterfield. Sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. And by Anacin for fast relief from pain of headache, uritis, and neuralgia. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our master of ceremonies.
Good evening, folks. This is Dean Martin. Well, it's time for another song and fun fest around the old NBC mic, and we're certainly glad you were able to join us. Jerry should be along at any minute now. On the way to the studio, he was supposed to stop in and see his doctor. We all got a little worried about Jerry this afternoon. You see, his temperature went up to 64. Well, anyway, until Mighty Mouse gets here, I'd like to get things underway with a touch of whispering. Stabolini, let's it go.
Whispering while you cuddle near me. Whispering so no one can hear me. Each little whisper seems to cheer me. I know it's true, there's no one there but you. You're whispering while you'll never leave me. Whispering why you'll never grieve me. Whisper and say that you believe me. Whispering that I love you. Whispering why you'll never leave me. Whispering why you'll never grieve me. Whisper and say that you believe me. Whispering that I love you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And now I'd like to...
Whispering while your arm is dangling.
Hey,
what's with the hey, hey? You want me to talk to me like a humane being?
Well, I just wanted to ask, must you always walk out here like that?
Like what? Like what? What's wrong the way I walked out? What do you want I should do, roll over?
No, I mean you're always so boisterous.
Sure I'm boisterous. What do you want I should be, girlstress? See, it's a play on words. He says boisterous, which means noisy, and I said girlstress. It's not really a word, but boy and girl, I put the word... Oh, I wish I was dead.
Come on now, Jer.
Now, the trouble is you don't want I should work at all. You don't want me out here at all.
Well, don't be silly, Jerry. Of course I want you to work.
Oh, no, you don't.
But I do want you to work. What makes you think I don't?
You just don't want it, because at the end of the week, when you get the money and I say, gimme, you say to me, what did you do?
Jerry, listen to me. In the first place, the money comes to both of us. And in the second place, why must you talk like an idiot?
If I don't talk like an idiot in the second place, there won't be any money in the first place.
You want to say your goddamn line, or don't you?
Nice place for the kitty.
I said that.
I heard it.
I know. Ah, Jerry.
Oh, Dean. I've hurt you. I wounded your pride with my cruel words. What can I do? What can I say?
What's happened to you, Germ? You were so kind and sweet. Remember how nice and good-natured you used to be?
Of course. Wasn't I a dog?
And now look at you. One minute you're nice, and the next minute you go wild. Honestly, you're ex-consistent.
Yeah, I know, but... Ex-consistent? Ex-consistent? For a minute, I thought he was wrong.
Look, Jerry, how about the program? We don't have a first guest.
Oh, well, that's not so serial. Why don't you and I do...
Not so what?
Let's think faster. I'm in 1A. I merely said, that's not so serial. See, the word is serious, but due to the fact that I'm an idiot, I say serious. It isn't really, because, well, why don't you and I do one of those dramatic scenes we do so well?
A dramatic scene?
Sure, one of those real tear-jerkers.
Well, all righty. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, Jerry and I give you our impression of a very tender scene. A man and a woman have a fight, and they are now trying to reconcile. I can't go any place.
Got no money.
I can't show my face.
You got pimples.
People stop and stare. Why, it's so hard to bear.
I know, Teddy.
Teddy?
It's so hard to bear, Teddy. Bear.
Well, everybody knows that you left me.
Because you were mean to me, you picked on me, you abused me, you pushed me around, and just how much of that nonsense do you think I could stand for?
Why, it's a tug of the town.
It's your mother, she can't keep her mouth shut.
Every time we meet, my heart gets the beat.
You like me.
We don't stop to speak, though it's been a week.
6 days, don't lie.
Why, everybody knows you left me.
Because you were mean to me and I just couldn't stand the torment.
It's the talk of the town.
It's your mother, do you hear me? She talks, talks, talks. Why, last Sunday, everyone in the neighborhood knew we had an argument. She has to tell every one of our affairs. Oh, God, is there no mercy?
Send out invitations to friends and our relations, announcing our wedding day.
And how well I remember me and my gray sequin gown. I loved that dress more than anything in the world. When I walked down that aisle and Mildred called it a rag, it broke my heart.
Friends and our relations, what I gave. Congratulations.
No present.
Nothing. How can I face them? My, what am I going to say?
You mean about the puppy?
Jerry!
Come on. Let's make up, sweetheart. We can't stay apart.
It's a physical attraction.
Don't let foolish pride keep you all from my side.
Coax me. Send me Halivar.
How can love like ours be ended? Oh, well, it's a talk of the town.
Now that that's out of our system, let's lend an ear to Jimmy Wallington.
Thank you, Dean. And now here's something of interest to everybody. At this point in our show every Friday night, ladies and gentlemen, we have a very tender and very romantic scene between a boy and a girl concerning dentine chewing gum and chiclets.
Guess what? I'm not bad breath.
Frankly, the only way that you can properly appreciate this little scene that I just told you about is to go out tonight, right after the broadcast, buy about a carload of each, dentine and chiclets, and then sit down, and Friday night, when we go on the air, you won't be surprised at this very breathtaking scene. And he fixed that line up. Good.
What is it?
Dentine playoff. Dentine playoff.
You know, I'd like a dime for every time I used the line to lighten the sentence when I was late for dinner. But whoever thought that here tonight I'd be singing I Ran All the Way Home.
I ran all the way home just to tell you that I'm sorry. I really didn't mean to be so mean to you. I ran all the way home just to hold you in my arms, dear. I always want you near to me, 'cause I love you. The moment I close the door behind me and I heard you cry, I knew I acted blindly, that I couldn't say goodbye. I ran all the way home. Just to beg you to forgive me. I want your love to be my own. Just mine alone. The moment I close the door behind me and I heard you cry, I knew I acted blindly, but I couldn't say goodbye. I ran all the way just to beg you to forgive me. I want your love to be my own, just mine alone.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Well, now comes the time for Jer and the boys to join me as we all sound off for Chesterfield.
Sound off for Chesterfield.
1,500 tobacco men have shown you before, and they'll show you again why Chesterfields are really best by mildness test.
They smell mild.
Chesterfield.
They smoke mild.
Chesterfield. Milder, 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 Chesterfield.
That's right.
A careful test, precise and exact. Scientists prove this important fact.
Oh, Chesterfield. I made it for. Sound off for Chesterfield.
1,500 tobacco men have shown you before, and they'll show you again why Chesterfields are really best. Really best by mildness test.
They smell mild.
Chesterfield.
They smoke mild.
Chesterfield.
Milder, 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 milder Chesterfield.
That's right.
A careful test, precise and exact. Scientists prove this important fact that Chesterfield in every case left no unpleasant aftertaste.
Mildness plus.
No aftertaste.
Mildness plus.
No aftertaste.
No unpleasant aftertaste in Chesterfield.
That's right.
Now if you're still a doubting Thomas, here's a thing that I can promise. Chesterfields will give you more. So when you're in the tobacco store,
sound off
for Chesterfield.
Sound off
for Chesterfield.
Try a pack of Chesterfield.
Do it!
Today!
What Jerry and I are trying to tell you folks is that Chesterfield Mildness Plus, no unpleasant aftertaste, is exactly what you want in a cigarette.
So try a pack of Chesterfield. Do it! Today!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Jerry and I are making a practice both on television and radio to introduce just as many new faces and personalities as we can possibly introduce. So tonight, we would like you to meet and hear a young lady that we had the pleasure of meeting a few evenings ago. She sings a wonderful song. We believe her future in this business is assured. Here she is now, the lovely Miss Bonnie Bishop.
Well, thanks a lot, Dean. I'm certainly happy to join up with you.
Well, it's nice having you around, Bunny. Say, they tell me you've been singing for quite a while.
Well, that's right. I started singing as a little girl in the shower.
Oh, I see. You're one of those soft soap sopranos.
I guess you might put it that way.
Well, if you can get along without your shower cap, we should do very nicely together. Let's have the downbeat, Richard.
I walked in with a smile, I walked out with a tear, while you danced, danced, danced.
At the place where we two had our first rendezvous, and we danced, danced, danced.
I came uninvited and I found you so thrilled and a lighter with someone new.
I walked in with a smile. I walked out with a tear.
And you danced, danced, danced.
I came uninvited, and I saw you so thrilled and delighted with someone new.
I walked in with a smile. I walked out with a tear.
And you danced, danced, danced.
Thank you, Bonnie. Thank you very, very much. Folks, it's been my pleasure to introduce a lot of nice people on this show, but no introduction has given me a bigger kick than the one I'm about to make now. Here's a man that Jerry and I have admired, respected for a long time. A wonderful guy, one of the country's most beloved comedians. Ladies and gentlemen, Danny Thomas.
Thank you. Hi, Dean. Thanks for the kind word. But what's all this, one of the country's most beloved comedians?
But you are beloved, aren't you?
Look, 90% of the time I'm on the road. I live in hotels, I work in saloons, I make faces into a television camera. I work all the time. I hold a dozen two-line conversations daily with bellboys and busboys, technicians and drunks. Twice a year I come home. My wife pecks me on the cheek. My kids say, "Who's he?" My mother-in-law locks herself up in her room. You call this beloved?
You comedians all talk alike, you know that? You all talk alike. Now you take my partner, Jerry.
No, you take your partner.
Don't, Danny, don't you like Jerry?
I was just kidding. I have a lot of respect for the lad.
That's good, because here comes the animal now.
Hey, Dean, is it time for me to come out and be adorable?
Who is that chap? He looks familiar.
Jerry, I want you to meet Danny Thomas. He's a great admirer of yours.
Dean, you know the admirers are supposed to gather at the stage door.
Jerry, this is Danny Thomas, the comedian.
Oh, goody, do you think he'll amuse me?
You were going to say abuse me, weren't you?
My subconscious mind was working.
Jerry, this is Danny Thomas, the comedian.
Oh, goody, you think he'll amuse me?
Well,
I don't like how well you two are working together.
Jerry, this is Danny Thomas, the comedian.
Oh, goody. Is he abusive?
Jerry, this is the abusive, Danny Thomas. Let's get this line in here.
Do you think he'll commode?
Listen, Dean.
What, Jerry?
No. This is me.
Look, I didn't come here to be a punching bag for this monkey on a stick.
I'll have none of that, sir.
Did you say he was a comedian? You invited another comedian on our show? I just realized. Well, if that's the way you want it, I'm through. THRU.
Oh, wait a minute. Don't get excited, Jerry. What's the matter with you?
You stay out of this, you team wrecker.
Jerry Louise, he's not splitting us up. He's just a guest. Look, if it'll make you feel better, I don't even like him, okay?
Oh, yes, you do. Don't lie. I can tell you like him.
How can you tell?
If he doesn't like you, how come he's letting you wear his old nose?
Can I help it if he's a coward and had his fixed?
I did have mine fixed. It used to be over here.
Yeah. Under the ear?
Wait a minute, Jerry. Wait a minute. You shouldn't be jealous. After all, I'm not a...
Are you going around the end or something?
Why do we all work like that?
Sure. We are the three Andrew sisters.
I want to be Patty or I won't play.
Patty Mac. Levine. Oh, to hell with it. Listen.
Oh, Jerry.
Hey, Jerry, will you hurry up? Jeannie might have the baby any minute.
Come yeah, on. That is right, you know.
Sure.
Let's go. I have a line to read.
Go ahead, won't you?
Thank you. Jerry, you shouldn't be jealous, really. I mean, you and I represent two different types of comedy. My comedy is that of a storyteller, weaving his tales of fancy over the hushed multitudes, holding them spellbound until the final word is spoken, catching their emotions in the palm of his hand.
You don't get laughs?
Of course I do, but we're worlds apart, Jerry. I like you, though. In fact, my whole family likes you.
They do?
Sure. You take, for example, my daughter, Teresa. Bless
no,
her.
You take her.
They do?
Yes. That's right. Next week, you sing.
I do?
My daughter, Teresa, always was one of my greatest fans, Jerry. When she saw me on television, like, she used to sit up and repeat over and over, "Daddy is funny. Daddy is funny." Then she saw you on television and became your most rabid fan. Now when she sees me, the words kind of come out different. She says, "Daddy is funny."
Gee, tell Teresa that I appreciate her loyalty.
You tell her. I haven't talked to her for 3 months.
Tell me, Danny, when you come back to radio, what kind of show would you like to do?
Well, I'll tell you, Dean, I go for the easy ones. You know, the quiz shows.
See, Dean, what I tell you, that's the kind of show we should have done, like Groucho Marx.
Well, no reason why we can't all do one now. Music, Rick.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Dean Martin, Jerry Lewis, and Danny Thomas are proud to present their version of that popular quiz program, You Bet Your Life, entitled... And now, ladies and gentlemen... Let's start over again.
Can we do the Chesterfield thing again?
Well, it's a good thing we aren't on live.
Stop the announcement.
His mother wanted him to be a plumber. Imagine him in your bathroom now.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Dean Martin, Jerry Lewis, and...
Gotta go back before that, please.
I've gotta go back.
Jimmy, stop kidding around.
You bet your life, Dean. Eight bars. Watch. Ready?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Dean Martin, Jerry Lewis, and Danny Thomas are proud to present their version of that popular quiz program, You Bet Your Life, entitled... No, You Bet Your Life. And here he is, your master of ceremonies.
Well, that's me, Groucho Marx. Martin. Well, I... Ready? Hey, Dick, if you can patch this up, I'm going to give you a chord.
Here we go.
Well, there goes the whole TV show.
You folks like milk or cream?
Oh, let up, will you, Jer? We got another one coming in.
Good.
Hey, Dick, what are you, goose and butterflies? Do something. We can't get any more laughs after this.
Oh, yes, we can. We'll talk dirty.
What the hell do you think we've been doing? All right, here we go.
Let's take it from Captain's Falls.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We know the answer to that one.
All right. Wait, hold it. I
want to
see how we sound.
Well, we nearly had it there.
Captain's Falls.
All right. Now?
Here we go. Go, Dick.
Well, our giant jackpot is up to $9,000 in round figures. Smooth them out and it comes to about 14 cents. George Feminine, who's our first couple?
Well, before we went on the air, the studio audience selected a sailor and a waitress as our first contestants. They're waiting off stage.
I got news for you, Feminine. I just peeked out there, and I think you better call our second couple.
Well, Groucho, for our second couple, the studio audience selected a peanut vendor and a parking lot attendant. Gentlemen, meet Groucho Martin.
Welcome to... No, you bet your life. And if either of you say the secret word, you will divide $1.35. It's something that hangs around the house.
I know, it's my father.
You must be the parking lot attendant.
How can you tell?
You look like you've been run over. And you, sir, you must be the peanut vendor. You must be the peanut. For a minute, I thought I was getting the last. And you, sir, you must be the peanut vendor.
That's right. I'm the Salvatore Pacciacalupi Paolo Garibaldi di Napoli, Junior the Two.
Good gosh, I've been teamed up with a Swede.
Hey, watch it. This is Swedes. I'm an all-American fellow. I'm born in Boston, Massachusetts.
Boston, Massachusetts. I thought I recognized the accent.
That's a funny. I don't know. I try all the time. I can't no fool of nobody.
This guy talks like he took the wrong teeth out of the glass.
Hey, Mr. Groucho. Who is this fellow? You look like a long string of spaghetti with a meatball on the top.
I'll find out right now. Tell me, son, what's your name?
My name is Marvin M. Mintz.
Marvin M. Mintz?
No individual laughter, lady. Laugh with everyone else and get the hell out of here.
Marvin M. Mintz. What's your middle name?
Marvin.
You mean your name is Marvin and Marvin Mintz?
Oh, no. No. No, it's Marvin Mintz. The accent's on the first Marvin.
But how come two Marvins?
Well, when I was small, I was a very difficult child. And when my mother used to call me, I wouldn't listen, and she'd have to say, Marvin, Marvin. So I'm Marvin, Marvin.
What would you rather be called, Marvin or Marvin?
My friends call me Sidney.
Mr. Bacigaloof, tell me something about yourself. Are you married?
Oh, my shows.
My shows? Oh.
I've been married to one woman for 32 years.
Oh, you have any children?
Mm-hmm. We got 31 bambinos.
Are they all well?
Oh, they all in the pink condition. But Mrs. Pachicolupi, she don't feel so good.
Well, that's all.
Yeah, you know, you never know where those measles are going to strike next.
Hey, how about getting on with the quiz? is I gotta get home before my mother.
Why?
I'm wearing her sneakers.
Easy now, Marvin. Don't get rambunctious. You say here now.
No, that's been tough.
That's all right. Well, if you win the $90,000, you can buy a pair of shoes. Shoes. Oh, his is written in the.
I got $9,000.
Oh, no.
Oh,
jeez. Take it from there.
All right.
I wonder where we're working tomorrow.
What the hell makes you think we're here tonight? Well, if you win the $9,000, you can buy a pair of shoes.
You mean we're going to get a chance at the jackpot? Boy, what I could do with $9,000, I'm going to buy a yacht.
Don't forget the federal tax.
Boy, I'm going to buy a motorboat.
And the state tax.
Yes, sirree, I'm going to buy a canoe.
And the excess tax, the gift tax, and the excess profit tax.
Anyone know where I can buy a used sailor cap?
All right, you have $20. How much do you want to bet? Remember, you're going to be paid. I can't even talk in my own voice. You got me doing this. All right. You have $20. How much you want to bet? After 4 days in the water and three in a boat, we finally penetrated into the interior of Africa. We took some pictures of the native girls, but they weren't developed.
Hey! We're going back next year.
All right. You have $20. How much do you want to bet? Now, remember, you're going for $9,000.
I don't know. I ask my partner. Hey, brushhead. We got a $20. How much you want to bet?
Let's bet a dime.
What's the matter? You crazy? You got a $20 and you're going to bet a dime?
All right. You're right. All right. Make it a nickel.
Hey, how come you such a cheapskate?
Mother raised me to be a miser.
Now, come on, make up your mind. We have other couples waiting.
I don't see no other couples.
We have another couple warming up backstage.
Oh, you know about the sailor and the waitress.
All right, Mr. Buckaloop. Oh, God. All right, Mr. Buckaloop. How do you say that? All right, Mr. Galoop. All right. Listen, Danny. All right, Mr. Buckaloop. Stand by for the jackpot question. If E is to X what L is to F, what is the sum total of the third equation? Talk it over thoroughly, but remember, we only allow one answer. Remember.
Well, I...
I'm time. Your sorry is up.
Are you sure you put your contact lenses in? I'm time your sorry is up.
My wife's gonna have a
baby. Throw me down the stairs, my hat. Throw a baby over the fence, some milk.
Well, I'm sorry, your time is up. Thank you, Mr. Buckethugloop. God.
You are Italian. How come you can't say that?
This is written in Spanish.
Bacchigaloop.
Oh, I'm sorry. Your time is up. Thank you, Mr. Bacchigaloop, for being with us, and better luck next time.
Well, goodbye, Mr. Grouch, and give my regards to Apo and to Chicklets.
There is no way to Ironically, Joe.
That's right. You ought to be ashamed of myself. What did I say?
Well,
that's what it says there.
Yes, it does. Well, what do you know about quiz shows?
What do we know about quiz shows?
Oh. What the hell is this today?
What is
Betty Collette?
You know what it is? We never do a radio show on a Wednesday. It's always Tuesday. I just figured it out. We shouldn't be here now.
What are you telling him for? Tell them.
Who needs them?
Walter O'Keefe gave me a brand new toaster.
All right, from the top. All right. What do we know about co-ed?
Walter O'Keefe gave me a brand new toaster.
Wouldn't this be priceless on film?
You ladies and gentlemen are not here at a great performance, but you're certainly here at a rare one.
All right, you want to start it, Mr. Danny?
Oh, sure. That's all I've got to do is stay here all night.
All right. Anytime you're ready.
What do we know about the
All right, now, when are you two picking out the furniture?
Ready?
I saw a lemon oak set for the dog.
Jerry! I had an uncle that acted that way, now he's my aunt.
I'm funny when you get to know me. I'm funny.
All right.
What do we know about
him? Oh, we have to say it together.
Yeah,
yeah, say it together.
What do we know about him?
They're not ready.
I'm pretty sure I need a job. I must, or I wouldn't be here.
No, you're ready.
No. All right. Well, will you give us, what do you know about quiz shows?
Well, what do you know about quiz shows?
What do we know about quiz shows?
Walter O'Keefe gave me a brand new toaster.
Double or nothing paid him off in dough.
Truth or Consequences gave a suitcase.
At Break the Bank, they told me where to go. It rhymes with swell.
Killer Bonnie gave us many prizes.
A stove, an iron, and a dinner gong. But Stop the Muses did the best of all for us. They gave us all the finish to this song. We had no...
From the top?
Come on now, hurry up and finish. All right, you ready?
You're Dean, I'll start first. You're Dean, wherever it's circled, red circle.
Double or nothing?
No, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, you ready? All right.
Walter O'Keefe gave me a brand new toaster. Go.
Double or nothing paid him off in dough.
Good.
Truth or Consequences gave a suitcase.
I break the bank, they told me where to go. It rhymes with swell. People are fine, he gave us many prizes.
A stove, an iron, and a dinner gong.
But Stop the Music did the best of all for us. They gave us all the finish to the song. We had no punchline. They gave us all the finish to the song.
Now see if you can do it.
Yeah.
Tell me where you live and I'll send the money.
You're going to join us on the alls?
Yeah.
There's some alls.
Alls, yeah.
Okay. Listen, and make the tag real free, huh, fellas? And then a little retard and we'll go home.
Okay.
All right. What do we know about them?
Oh, well, all right.
Romantic, Dean Mark.
Well, what do you know about quiz shows?
What do we know about quiz shows?
All right, here we go.
Wait. They ran out of tape. Spot the cell, focus.
Oh,
What's serious? There's nothing serious about it. The year I had the hernia, I'll tell you.
Now Bubble's dandruff will come out. All right. Well, what do we know?
But
that's what you know about
him.
That's what I
said.
But you said
push shows before. Don't put the blame on me, Harvey.
I was just going to say, give me a puff.
Who took the clothes from the clothesline?
I got it.
Who took the clothes?
All right, what do you know about quiz shows, right? Okay.
Well, we weren't born here.
We're certainly dying. Well, what do you know about quiz shows?
What do we know about quiz shows?
Walter O'Keefe gave me a brand new toaster.
Double or nothing paid him off in dough.
Truth the consequences gave a suitcase.
Break the bank, they told me where to go. It rhymes with swell.
People are funny, gave us many prizes.
A stove, an iron, and a dinner gong.
But stop the music, did the best of all for us. They gave us all the finish to this song. We had no punchline. They gave us all the finish to the song.
Well, let's all return to the state of sanity for about 1 minute and listen to Jimmy Wallington. Now, he's not even ready.
With your kind permission, I'll do my part after everybody's gone home. Is that all right, Dick?
You're a smart guy.
Okay.
Playoff.
I sell headache powder. Right now, I'm going out and get some.
If you have a headache, stick your head through the window and the pain will be gone. What else can you say?
Oh, well, it's a
After
joke.
I say I'm sorry.
He's having his fifth baby.
Not me, my wife.
Yeah, his wife. Isn't this wonderful? See, you wouldn't listen to me. You wouldn't drink Ovaltine.
Jerry.
All right.
It was due at 8:30.
What?
All right, playoff.
Some years ago, before I ever dreamed of singing professionally, I was working in a grocery store in my hometown. Now, you don't really need a band to sing with when you feel the urge. And so it was my habit to sing to the tinny accompaniment of the rattling cans I was pyramiding on the shelves. Well, one day I was stacking a few cans of cranberry sauce, humming a long-forgotten tune, when I
realized that someone was standing quietly near me. She couldn't have been more than 17 and just as pretty as a spring day. I don't know how long she had been standing there, but it sure was nice to know I had been serenading someone. And when she asked me to sing a special song, well, my joy was just about complete. I guess this was the first person to show any real interest in my voice, and I know I'll never forget her. What's more, I'll never forget the song. Wherever you are, Stella, this one is for you. You don't like Stella.
What's worse, you got down here Geneva. What do you want me to say? Geneva? All right, I'll fix it up. I'll never forget the song. So wherever you are, Fred, this one is... All right, we'll take it. I'll put it. I better put in my wife's name or I don't go home.
This one we can never put together.
If you people hear this at 9 o'clock Friday, you call me and let me know.
I guess this was the first person to show any real interest in my voice, and I know I'll never forget her. What's more, I'll never forget the song. Wherever you are, Jeannie, this one is for you.
I walked in.
Lucky thing, I taped this before the show. Thank God I did. Time for a song. Danny said, "Who says radio is dead?" You're right.
Well, let's just get... Let go, let go. Oh.
Here, what'll I do here?
Yeah.
Guard it, please. It's the only one left. All right.
Hey,
you don't have to put your feet under mine.
All right. Ready? Some years ago, before I never... Oh, anybody want to lay a price on this? Some years ago, before I ever dreamed of singing professionally, I was working in a grocery store in my hometown. Now, you don't really need a band to sing with when you feel the urge. And so, it was my habit to sing the... Put your hand down. You look like you're going to float away. I better do this when everybody's went. All right. Somebody said do it now. Some years ago, before I ever dreamed of singing professionally, I was working in a grocery store in my hometown. Now, you don't really need a band to sing with when you feel the urge. And so it was my habit to sing to the tinny, tiny... I can't... Let's skip this, and we'll do it. I'll stay after school. I'll do it after school, and we'll go right into the laced part.
Look at this job you've made for my mother.
Look at the job your mother made. I'll stay after school.
All right, let's get song applause. Song applause. Song applause. T. Dean, I think you're the greatest singer in the country.
Well, thanks, Jer.
How you'll do in the city, I don't know. But in the country, you're great.
Well, that's really nice singing, Dean. But I still can't get over that fine Groucho impersonation.
Yeah, that was swell. You know something, Danny? I'll bet you do a great imitation of Chico.
Hey, we ought to make a picture someday, Dean. You do Groucho, I'll do Chico, and... Oh, who will you do, Jerry? Jerry, who will you do?
Jerry, that's the nicest sound that's come from you in years.
Well, good night, fellas, and good night, my career. Thanks, all.
So, folks, hope to see you again next week. Until then, this is Dean Martin.
And Jerry Lewis reminding you that we appear on radio through the courtesy of Hal Wallace Productions, producers of our current release, That's My Boy, and our new picture, Sally Beware. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
From Hollywood, you'll just heard transcribed the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show. Written by Ed Simmons and Norman Lear. Produced and directed by Dick Mack, with music under the direction of Dick Stabile. Brought to you by Dentine, the gum with the breath-taking flavor. And Chiclets, the candy-coated gum with a flavor that won't chew out. By Chesterfield, sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. And by Edison, for fast relief from pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia.
Wonderful hand for a gentleman who took an awful lot of abuse and something that he's certainly not accustomed to, Mr. Danny Thomas, a wonderful... course, our very capable and wonderful maestro, who does get dizzy, Dick Stabile and the orchestra. And, of course, the debut on our show of the lovely and charming and wonderful Miss Bunny Bishop. Bunny? Last, and certainly by no means least, our strong arm and friend, Mr. Jimmy Wallington.
Incidentally, ladies and gentlemen, this is the only script in one piece on the entire stage. Would you mind sitting here for a minute until the opening?
Good night, Danny. Thanks, Danny. And don't forget to send the money.
If you remember, ladies and gentlemen, we started with a big laugh.
Yeah, right from the beginning.
If you remember, we started with a big laugh. Remember, Jerry said something about this boom B, kick him in the knees, this boom bass, kick him in the other knee. Jerry, come back and do it, man. Oh, have you? Okay. From Hollywood, we present the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show. Brought to you by Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor, and Chiclet, the candy-coated gum with a flavor that won't chew out. By Chesterfield, sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. And by Anacin for fast relief from pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our master of ceremonies.
Hi, folks, this is Dean Martin. Well, it's time for another song and fun fest around the old NBC mic.
Sit down. What do you need, Dick? Hurry
closing.
Up.
Closing.
Last scene.
Can you take the good night, Jerry and Dean?
Jerry.
Can you pause a minute? I'll do the music, Jerry.
My wife's got the kid, I know.
Always. Hold
on. You keep yours?
No, I'm going to keep this one for a minute. I got to get ready for this.
Sometimes I wonder why I spend my life.
We're better on television.
I got it, darling. That's Jean, our script girl. I didn't hear you.
I don't mind a few people walking out in the back, but they're beginning to walk towards us. Let's hurry.
Oh, yeah. And so, folks, hope to see you again next week. And until then, this is Dean Martin.
And Jerry Lewis reminding you that we appear on radio through the courtesy of Hal Wallace Productions, producers of our current release, That's My Boy, and our new picture, Sailor Beware.
Night, folks.
Good night, everybody.
From Hollywood, you have just heard transcribed the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show, written by Ed Simmons and Norman Lear, produced and directed by Dick Mack, with music under the direction of Dick Stabile. Brought to you by Dentine, the gum with a breathtaking flavor, and Chiclet, the candy-coated gum with a flavor that won't chew out. By Chesterfield, sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. And by Anacin for fast relief from pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia.
Thank you very much. God bless you. Good night. Well,
you want a commercial, don't you? Right. You want a commercial?